Hey, I'm Lexi Shimoto, and I'm 15 years old. I'm from the OC. I've been dancing for about 7 years.
Hey, it's Madison. I'm 14 years old, and I'm from Orange County, California.
Hi, everybody. I'm Sage Humphreys. I'm 16 years old.
Hi, my name is Andrea. I am 15 years old, and I'm from Huntington Beach, California. And I'm really excited for you to follow me through this whole experience.
There we go, that's it, good. And bum, bum, bum.
It is going to be one of the biggest years for me. I am competing in Youth America Grand Prix, one of the biggest ballet competitions in the whole world.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to welcome you at the Youth America Grand Prix, where students handpicked from over 30 countries will perform before the leaders in the international world of dance.
Out of 5,000 kids that we see, we'll probably have 250 or 300 soloists who will make it to New York for a chance to be the next ballet star.
They will compete for over $300,000 in scholarships to the world's leading dance academies.
There's a few different categories. You can perform in classical variation or contemporary. So there's the pre-competitive, there's the junior and the senior. And you can also do duets and trios. So it's good where you can have just lots of performing opportunities.
So what time does it end at night? I mean, do you it's all finished at 10 o'clock and then you get back, start again the next morning at 8 or something?
We don't know. It's our first year.
Team.
Yeah.
This is my first YGP and I'm just super excited to see how it turns out.
Maybe next year you can do contemporaries. Those are like, it's good because then you don't have to think so much about the classical. YGP is a really big deal for me this year because I'm kind of hoping to get scholarships and I'm hoping to be seen by some company directors.
I'm so nervous for YGP right now. I'm rehearsing every day, which has been a lot lately, but I want it to be the best.
Everything to your maximum, and I know you're going to do it great.
All I want to do is just place at YGP and get my name out there.
Awesome exposure. It's just a place where, you know, the world gets to view you.
I've seen a lot of videos of people performing at YGP. It just seems like a place where you can really practice and you can really get an experience of the real thing, you know? This is what we want to do for our lives, and so you get to learn about what you want
to
do.
You have to have so many components to become a ballet dancer.
The perfect body.
Not too tall, not too short.
The flexibility, the musicality, discipline.
Again, try this again. Try this again, Madison.
I call it fire in the belly. What makes that person special and different from other dancers?
Ballet dancers are athletes, but ballet dancers are actors as well.
It's not real, it's a stage. You have to be really including that upper body. You have to dance.
The ballet career is, I think, one of the most unappreciated career because you don't get paid, your career is very short, you have tons of injury, and people still do it despite all odds because they cannot not do it.
You don't go into this career to make a lot of money. It's an art form.
I'm basically expressing everything through my art.
It's this thing where your soul meets your body.
It's music, movement, expressing yourself.
I don't even know if happy is the right word. It's better than words can describe to be on stage.
You feel that energy from the audience and everybody is supporting you and just enjoying your dancing. That's all that I want. That's what I live for as a dancer.
I would sacrifice basically anything for ballet. Like, ballet comes like first.
On a scale of 1 to 10, my life is about a 100. On the stressful level right now?
Every day, it's usually wake up about 6 to 6:30, eat breakfast, stretch, go to conservatory classes from 8 all the way to 5 o'clock usually. Then I'll go to West Coast School of the Arts, go all the way to rehearsal from about 9 to 10, go home, eat dinner, and homework. Hopefully I get rest and then we'll just start that all over again.
You kind of have to decide on things that you want to give up.
You know, high school and homecoming and there's a prom.
It's like right now I'm picking ballet. But that's getting a little bit tougher as like I get older and stuff.
And not everybody has this determination and focus and this willingness to sacrifice absolutely everything.
Go.
Chest up, and chasse, no. You're doing pencil turns there.
My ultimate goal in ballet is definitely to get a professional contract.
My ultimate goal is joining a company and having everyone know me as a professional dancer.
My ultimate goal is to be a principal dancer in a company. I want to perform, you know, those ballets that I've always dreamed of dancing.
Ultimately, I do want to become a professional, and that's what I'm going to strive for every single day.
You have 15, maybe 20 years if you're lucky, to have a dance career. So if you don't make it right then and there, it'll be very hard. Their dream, everything they have ever done in their lives, will either get a green light into the future or they'll have to fend for themselves.
Everything is built up to this moment, and now I just have to let go.
You start with the discipline, 100% concentration in the studio. Again, I teach them how to work hard, but at the same time, you know, they come from the other studios, they don't know what it is.
How nervous do you get when you dance?
It's always been this thing of, Madison, you're too stressed out. Madison, you need to stop being so tight.
Because I'm telling you, get nervous, it will take a lot out of you.
He certainly has a good reputation. He has a lot of dancers and professional companies and professional schools, but sometimes he's kind of like, bulldog?
Stop. What did I just say?